voting. One of the greatest powers Black and brown people have in this country is the ability to cast a vote. And yet, every election, politicians tell Black and brown people not to exercise that power. What do I mean? I mean, politicians love it when Black and brown people just get in line and cast a ballot. But have you ever noticed what happens the moment a Black or brown person decides to step out of line?
You have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't Black.
That's right. They're no longer Black. They're no longer brown. They're sellouts, pick-me's, Uncle Tom's. The name-calling isn't an accident. That's by design. It's a tactic to keep Black and brown people in line. But here's the truth. If you aren't holding both political parties accountable and speaking truth to power on both sides of the political spectrum, then you aren't voting. All you're doing is casting a ballot. Now, I know what some of you are thinking. Brandon wants us to vote Republican. But that's where you're wrong. See, I don't care if you vote Democrat. I don't care if you vote Republican. I don't care if you vote third party. I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I know what is best for you. But I do know this much. If something isn't working out for you, your family, and your community, and you continue to vote for the same people, don't be surprised when you get the same result. Because the ability to fix these problems largely depends on the motivation of voters to hold the people in power accountable. And when you give your vote away to the same politician or party every election, you give away your political power. So as we go into the upcoming election, I challenge you to exercise your power by stepping out of line and doing what is best for you, your family, and your community. Don't let fear convince you to give up that power. That's what the people in power want. And that is my word of the day.